On today's show, FCA's head of sales is in big trouble with U.S. law enforcement. Inventory levels soar to the highest level in a dozen years, and Formula One has a new owner. All that and more coming right up on Autoline Daily. This is Autoline Daily for September 8th of 2016. Looks like Reid Bigland could be in big trouble. He's the head of all sales at Fiat Chrysler. As we reported back in late July, the U.S. Department of Justice and the Securities and Exchange Commission began investigating FCA's sales numbers. The company bragged it had 75 months of unbroken sales increases, but it turns out that sales streak actually ended 3 years ago. FCA reportedly encouraged dealers to report new cars as sold, then turn around and put them in their used car lot. That kept the sales streak going. Amazingly, it did not take many cars to make a difference. Of the 7.7 million vehicles FCA sold in the U.S. market over the last 6 years, only 4,500 of them were involved in this scheme. But because FCA bragged about its sales streak to shareholders and investors, the DOJ and the SEC are getting involved. And here's where it gets dangerous for Reid Bigland. The DOJ is no longer just going after corporations. Now it's going after executives too. The thinking is that individuals must be held responsible for their actions, not just the companies they work for. And here's our Autoline insight. Volkswagen executives, beware. This strongly suggests the DOJ will be coming after you. Formula One is changing hands. Its majority shareholder, CVC Capital Partners, just sold out to Liberty Media for $8.4 billion. Even so, the controversial CEO of F1, Bernie Ecclestone, is not going away. The 85-year-old has run the sport for nearly 40 years and will probably stay on until they pry it from his cold, dead fingers. Formula One actually has 10 major stakeholders. Ecclestone owns just over 5% of the operation, but even the teacher retirement system of Texas owns 3% and earns a very handsome dividend each year that goes to pay for teachers' pensions. Coming up next, China cracks down on companies that are making electric cars illegally.
Autoline Daily is brought to you by Bridgestone Tires, your journey, our passion. Dow Automotive Systems, advanced materials that deliver better results. And by Lear, a global leader in automotive seating and electrical systems.
Just last week, we reported how the Chinese government thinks it has too many EV makers. Very soon, it's going to get rid of one of them. China's Ministry of Finance says that five domestic automakers cheated on its program to subsidize electric vehicles. They received about 1 billion yuan, or roughly $150 million in illegal payouts. The largest violator will have its production license revoked, while the other companies will get fined. None of the major car makers were involved. Generous incentives led to the creation of over 200 new EV startups. But now the government is working to weed out the cheaters and the weak ones. All right, imagine yourself owning a supercar, and the only thing it needs is a new set of tires. Probably because you roasted off the old set. No problem, right? Tires can be expensive, but they're easy to come by. Well, not if you're an owner of a Jaguar XJ220. The car, which first came out in 1992, had a top speed of 213 miles per hour, so it required a special compound that won't shred apart at high speeds. But companies stopped producing the tires that would fit the supercar a number of years ago because of their oddball size. Well, now Bridgestone is stepping in to help. The tire maker says it will have a new tire ready for next year for the Jaguar's 25th anniversary. And because of advances in tire technology, they will likely outperform the original tires. Still to come, with sales slowing down in the U.S., automakers are sitting on a pile of inventory.
For the people at Dow, racing is a sport and a science. We enjoy one and learn from the other. But like most competitive people, we like winning at both. This is the human element at work. Dow.
There's more car news and industry insight from the Autoline Network every day. Take a moment to click that subscribe button. You'll never miss another Autoline episode.
Automakers in the American market were caught off guard when sales slowed in August. Now Ward's Auto reports that inventory levels are at a 12-year high. Get this, there are now 3.5 million vehicles sitting on dealers' lots. The biggest problem is with passenger cars. At the other end of the scale, there is something of a shortage for small pickups. All that inventory translates into 62 days of supply, which isn't all that bad. But Ward says it does not expect to see any increases in production for the rest of the year. And before we go, don't forget that Autoline After Hours is coming up later this afternoon, and we're going to have a 1952 Hudson Hornet in the studio. That's the car that dominated NASCAR in the early years. And here's a little known fact. The city of Detroit played an important role in NASCAR's formative years. This is a fascinating story that is not well known. So join John and Gary for some of the best insights into the automotive industry. That's starting at 3 p.m. Eastern Time at www.autoline.tv. But that wraps up today's report. Please join us again here tomorrow.